Hi everyone, so you may have noticed that my background is different. College just started and I'm trying to figure out how I'm gonna film and where I'm gonna film, and since I'm not living home anymore, I don't have my beautiful bookshelf behind me. I also haven't really decorated and I don't know when I'm gonna decorate, so please bear with this bare background for the moment. So today is Wednesday and I have decided that I'm going to make this my very first Top 5 Wednesday video. If you don't know, Top 5 Wednesday is a Goodreads group created by Lainey from Ginger Reads Lainey and is now hosted by Sam from Thoughts on Tomes. I'll leave both of their channels down below as well as the Goodreads group in case you're interested. This week's topic is books for your younger self. So basically this is like books that you think that you would have valued or would have enjoyed more if your younger self would have read them, something that showed a new experience or a lesson that you think would have been valuable to have read as a younger person. This topic was kind of weird for me because I'm only 18, so my younger self is kind of relative. I can only go so far back. The first book I have is, actually it's not a book, it's a play, is No Exit by Jean-Paul Sartre, which I know, very weird because I primarily read YA. This is a classic French play. It basically follows these three people who are in hell. They're stuck in this room in hell together and we just kind of learn about how they got there and how they're doing in hell together. It's not a happy play. The reason I chose No Exit is primarily because of its huge theme of existentialism, which is a term that I kind of threw around all the time when I was younger. Younger as in like 2 years ago. Basically about Sartre's philosophy is very much hindered on existentialism, and through that we learned about existential crises, which is pretty much when you don't really know whether you're doing something because you want to, or if it's because of society, or because of external forces telling you to do something. And I soon learned that basically the college application process, as well as college decisions, is basically a giant existential crisis. And I read this book during that crisis, so I guess it kind of fit well into what was going on, but maybe if I would have come in with some knowledge of what I was getting into, I would have been a little more prepared. But really, I don't think anyone is ever prepared for college application season. The next book I have is Since You've Been Gone by Morgan Matson. I read this past summer and I definitely really enjoyed it when I read it. Since You've Been Gone is pretty much about this girl named Emily, and at the beginning of the summer she finds out that her best friend has gone missing. But she soon finds that her best friend leaves her list of 13 things that she wants Emily to do by the end of the summer. And Emily now ventures to complete the list because she thinks that if she completes it, she'll find a way to get to her best friend. Now, a really big core of the story is Emily's journey into finding herself and learning to be more independent and trying new things and get out of her comfort zone. Granted, this is very stereotypical, it's a Bildungsroman, coming of age story, they're not that hard to find. But I think I related very much to the main character, and I think that lesson of branching out, not being afraid to make new friends and try new things is definitely something that my younger self needed and I continue to need. But overall, I think if I had read this maybe around middle school or beginning of high school, I think, I don't know if it would necessarily change who I am, but it might have introduced something new to my way of thinking. The next book I have is Magnus Chase and the Gods of Asgard. Not really one particular book in the series, just generally the whole trilogy. I really wish 10-year-old me got to see Samira Elabas fully in action. If you watch my review of Saints and Misfits by S.K. Ali, then you know my feelings about representation and how important it is, especially for younger viewers. When I read this book, I was maybe like 15 or 16, and it never really occurred to me until I read this book how much I craved seeing someone of Middle Eastern descent or a Muslim character in a fantasy setting in a way that was positively portrayed. Because fantasy is really not a very diverse genre. It's getting better, but it's really not the best. And I grew up thinking that that's just the way things are. I was never gonna get a story of someone like me. So I wish that when I was 10 years old and began falling in love with fantasy, that I could have had that experience, that I could have seen myself in the genre that I love. The Magnus Chase series has loads of diversity aside from Samira, and that just makes me so happy because I'm so glad that kids now get to see themselves in these amazing fantastical worlds. Next I have Turtles All the Way Down by John Green. This book is essentially about a girl named Aza who has severe OCD. There's also a subplot with like mystery and a millionaire and stuff, but like the main core of this novel is just about Aza and her dealing with OCD. It was really eye-opening for me to see this own voice's portrayal of mental illness. It's super common that people overuse the word OCD and make it a stereotype of being organized and tidy and liking things to be neat, when in reality, it's so much more complex than that. By the time I read this book, I had already been educated and informed about mental illness, at least to some extent. So this is definitely something that I wish that a middle school me had read, so I could really be knowledgeable about something that I personally didn't go through. And I hope that also would inspire me from an early age to research mental illness, to talk to people about it, and to not normalize ableist language. Segueing on to my last pick is The Hate U Give by Angie Thomas. This is similar to Turtles in that it just basically opened my eye to something that I may have known about, but I had not known the extent of it. And for The Hate U Give, it really was a learning experience. The book is about a girl named Star Carter who lives in her primarily black neighborhood but goes to a white private school. And in the beginning of the novel, she is the sole witness to a case of police brutality. There is so much discussion about, obviously, police brutality, but also interracial relationships, gang violence, just the different culture, and what it's like to live in our contemporary society with all these continual racial tensions that a lot of people just tend to ignore. I'm ashamed to admit, I didn't know virtually anything about police brutality until I was a freshman in high school and I started reading the news, and until I began studying history. And this book really helps you to understand the consequences of history that continually impact the black communities. So 100%, I wish that I had read this book when I was younger. And I definitely don't think that I lost something by reading this book now. It's the opposite, actually. I definitely was enlightened and informed about so many different topics. But again, that would have been great to have just that really easy, accessible foundation of that discussion as a younger reader. All right, that's all I have. Please let me know what books you would pick and leave a comment down below. Don't forget to like and subscribe, and I'll see you next time.